Hello, welcome back to the fifth and final of the regression, or at least of this set of regression videos for GEOG 300, Geographical Data Analysis at WVU. Here we're looking at the presentation of our ordinary least squares regression. So, first would be the conventions of, as with other techniques, what gets presented, what doesn't get presented. Like with ANOVA or the t-test, you get a lot of information in your output, especially from ArcGIS. So what you would put in your table would be the intercept or beta zero, the coefficient or beta, and the overall relationship or R squared. And you also put in the all three associated p values. Include the intercept only if it is meaningful within the context of that study, of that analysis. If, for example, the value of x equals zero isn't going to show up, then there's no need to interpret what happens to the dependent variable if x equals zero. To borrow from that previous example, if I am presenting on the effect of a county's income upon its political voting habits, I'm not going to bother with the intercept, because finding a county that actually has zero income, you're not going to have that. It doesn't exist. So why bother trying to interpret that intercept that is never going to be found, so to speak, in nature? So only put it in if you need to, in terms of the interpretation. It is still included within the table of the output, because basically that needs to provide enough information to recreate that regression line. That includes the intercept, even if it doesn't really exist as a meaningful thing within the interpretation or the discussion. Next, beware of the assumptions. So, what I just presented in the previous video, that, okay, the errors are normally distributed, that you don't have some relationship between your independent variable and the errors, that kind of cone shape that I showed. Fancy term for that is that the errors must be homoscedastic, which is that the variance doesn't change. That term people like to, you'll see it sometimes if you're working within academic articles about statistics that use regression. Most people obviously don't know the terms homoscedastic or heteroscedastic, where there is a relationship between the error and the independent variable. So those terms exist, you may see them, but probably won't. And the assumption of independence, which is really kind of the big one for spatial analysis. Likewise, make sure that when you're talking about R squared and talking about P, the P value, make sure you get the interpretations correct. That, I can tell you, is probably the single most common interpretation mistake I have seen in 10 plus years of teaching this course. The other assumption, or shouldn't say assumption, the other convention here that we would see for regression is beware of the ecological fallacy. Especially if you are doing a relationship on aggregated data. It's hard to say how many times, again, I have seen, again, to keep that same example of income and voting preference, that is the overall, the median income of a county. And if we say, okay, as the income of a county goes up, the proportion in that county voting for the Democrats also goes up. That does not always translate. That does not guarantee that the individual voters who are wealthier are consistently voting for Democrats. Even if the relationship is there at the overall county aggregated scale, watch out for the ecological fallacy and don't write up as if it is true for individual voters. Excuse me. So, again, be very careful at that. Another thing which I have seen on occasion, but not nearly as much, don't flip your variables. Remember which is the dependent variable, which is the one you are predicting, and which is the independent variable, or the one you assume you already know. So if you're using income to predict the percent voting for Democrats, don't flip around and start talking as if you're using the percent voting for Democrats to predict the income of a county. As I said, that's not as common, but I have seen it happen. Watch out for that interpretation pitfall, I guess, or write-up pitfall. So the main things to bear in mind when you're writing up the regression, just to summarize. As with everything, make sure you justify your choices. Justify the choice of independent and dependent variable. Make sure that your table includes these six values. And at least for the purposes of this class, only those six values. You'll get a whole lot more coming out, especially of ARC. But most of that will not make it into your final table. I have looked at I don't know how many academic articles that use regression, and even then, they sometimes might add a little bit, but usually we'll stick to these values and just those values. Interpret the intercept only if it makes sense to do so. Only if it actually gives you useful information for, as we are always doing, developing a hypothesis, or developing a policy, taking action, doing something with the data. If you cannot use that intercept, don't bother interpreting it. Beware of the assumptions from the pitfalls video. Beware of the ecological fallacy as well. And keep your dependent and independent variables straight as you are doing your interpretation. So that is things to keep in mind when you are presenting regression results. And as always, if you have questions, feel free to ask in class. Please send me an email. I'll take any questions through either of those means. And that is it for this introduction to regression. I will see you at the next video when we continue our discussion into additional versions or additional forms of regression. Thank you for watching. Have a good one.